Hello everyone and welcome to another episode of Let's Play Evil Genius. So even though, like, really only one person has asked for it at this point, but I'll just go ahead and do a super quick rundown of how you set up traps. I'm not actually going to build any, but here we go. I'm just going to pause this real quick so my guys don't actually build anything while I'm doing this. So what you do, you just go and you select traps. You select one of the three methods of how to activate it. So let's go ahead and put down a pressure pad. There's one. And then you go ahead and select the trap that you want to go ahead and link it up to. We'll go ahead and pick the nerve gas. And then just like that, bam. So you put the trap down, you have a way to activate it. You then select the traps, and they got these little circle bits. So you select one, link it to the other, boom, trap set up. Simple as that. You can get more complicated, you can attach multiple traps to one sensor, so on and so forth. I don't really use traps a whole bunch. I really don't. So we just gotta get rid of those. But yeah, that's how you set up traps. I might set up some on the second island, but I wouldn't hold my breath. Mostly I like to rely on my PR minions and misdirection. Traps are a little bit dangerous. Mostly if you put traps in an area where it's too busy, you risk hitting your own minions, which, you know, like the nerve gas trap or even the bee traps, which I researched off camera, might, you know, do you some good. Oh, also, once you set up traps, you can place the crash test dummy, and it'll send several crash test dummies in whichever direction, like, you select it, you point it in a direction, and it'll send dummies out, and that's how you test to see how good your traps are. But, I mean, like I said, I don't really like to use a whole lot of traps, so don't expect to really see that many. Definitely don't expect to see any on this island. But, what else was I talking about? Oh, right, so if you put a trap in too high an area, you risk catching your own minions in it. If you set up, like, a booby-trapped corridor specifically for agents to get, you know, suckered into, that could be a little bit more useful. But it's not always a great bet. Let me go ahead and pause this while I'm talking. Because I did have my minions start to steal this first totem pole, and I want that as soon as possible. Let's actually go ahead and call these guys home as soon as they're done with that. Or maybe not. Because if they fail, I want them there as a staging. And they are plotting. I'll go ahead and leave them plotting. There's nothing too dangerous. Oh, also, I got the order wrong for the super agents. It's actually Smash, and then Anvil, and then Hammer, and then Patriot, and then Saber. So expect to... We'll be seeing this guy, this super agent, fairly soon. And he's terrifying, but workable. So, also, I think in an earlier video, I said that the Matron has an ability that stops agents in their tracks. It's actually Lord Kane, who is not here. Where the hell is Lord Kane? He's out in the world doing stuff. Yeah, it's actually Lord Kane. So I'm probably going to want to recall him as soon as Mariana Mamba shows up for the first time, which is going to be just awful. just awful. I mean, she's not that dangerous. But, you know, super agents.
Good evening. This
Yay!
Is a World Service broadcast. There
no,
is increasing evidence
you.
That the evil organization is trying to reassemble an infamous red Indian totem
Go
pole.
Away the hell
After
here.
The totem pole was looted by colonial ethnographers and carved up into four sections, a curse was placed on it by the tribal elder. Legend has it that if the pieces are reunited, the curse will be lifted.
Okay, where is the second piece? I know there's one on the west coast. I think there's one in central Russia. I think the last one is in the Middle East. Well, whatever. I need to raise my notoriety anyway in order to find them. But yeah, so I'm gonna go ahead and do some notoriety grinding. We're gonna get it up relatively high. So we can reveal the last of these totem pole pieces. Also, there's another optional quest that I need to try to reveal down here in Antarctica, but like I said, I'm going to go ahead and do some notoriety. Mostly, we're going to stay away from Smash for now. That was a weird jump. Anyway, so yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and cut the video here. I'm gonna do a couple of notoriety missions, just mostly money grind some more. Once Mariana shows up for the first time, I'll definitely go ahead and come back and show you guys that little snippet. But see you guys in a bit. Okay. So apparently shit's on fire right now. What is this guy? An investigator? Oh, it's this douche. Kill him, please. I don't know what the hell he's doing. Oh, he's throwing stars. Go ahead and kill this guy, too. Damn it. Well, explosions, I guess? You know what it is? It's because I had things in here that were... Kills them all! This type of behavior is unacceptable. And I don't know what the hell my valets are doing, but it's not their job. Yeah, it's because I had stuff in here that was... damn it! Had heat on it, and the infiltrator saw it and blew it up. So, not good. Not good. No, no, no. There we go. Damn it. Okay, maybe the one fire extinguisher is a bad idea. Let's go ahead and do something about this room. You know what, I'll do that off camera, but we need to put a door here. Anyway, oh, something else. You guys need to get it. I went ahead and did some stuff with these outdoor shacks. Hopefully this will provide some more diversions for any incoming infiltrators and things like that. I mean, we're going to be hearing more high security door breached, even if they're not inside my base, but... the hell was that? Oh! This is what the Playboy does to the women. Forgot to show this off. Oh, he didn't do it. It's supposed to make her all swoony. Well, anyway. You. No. You. Give me... not evil genius.
Weekend tag issued.
The regular minions.
Warning. Hostile presence detected in base.
I might have to spend some money to do some more maintenance. Well, I'm obviously going to spend some more money to do some more maintenance. But, oh, right. Go ahead and hide. I forgot these guys were up here. So, the second totem pole popped. The... Azerbaijan. That's not Indian at all, I don't think. Or I'm saying it wrong. Anyway, obtain the second section of the cursed totem pole. We need 5 guards. We only take them 30 seconds, but right now there is a...
security door bypassed.
Hammer justice present. Look out! I don't think I've ever read this. Look out! It's an agent of justice. While this piece is present in a region, your minions will suffer great attrition, and acts of infamy will be more dangerous to carry out. Hide! So, hiding is useful. I never actually talked about hide, I don't think. So, plotting and stealing is obvious. Oh my god, lady. You know, after all this time, I think I finally really will actually turn her down. That's the sound quality, though, not sound volume. Music, sound effects volume. There we go. That'll shut her up, or at least make her a lot more quiet. Anyway, as I was saying, what was I saying? Oh, right. the hide and plotting and stealing. Yay, she's gone. Steal. So basically, plotting and stealing, fairly obvious. You plot, you steal. Actually, let's go ahead and steal. We need the money. Hiding makes your agents invisible. They will never die as long as hiding is turned on. Heat actually decreases. It's a fairly useful stat, or fairly useful ability. The thing that sucks about it is hiding turns itself off automatically after 2 minutes.
Good evening. This is a World Service broadcast. There is increasing evidence that the evil organization is trying to reassemble an infamous Red Indian totem pole. After the totem pole was looted by colonial ethnographers and carved up into four sections, a curse was placed on it by the tribal elder. Legend has it that if the pieces are reunited, the curse will be lifted.
I don't know what I'm doing. I'm still recording while I'm just placing shit. Anyway, that was a lot of dead air. I apologize for that. Anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and cut this here, and we'll be back when something else happens. See you guys in a bit.
Is a World Service broadcast.
Totem pole
number
3.
There is increasing evidence that the evil organization is trying to reassemble an infamous Red Indian totem pole. After the totem pole was looted by colonial ethnographers and carved up into four sections, a curse was placed on it by the tribal elder. Legend has it that if the pieces are reunited, the curse will be lifted.
Object will be moved shortly. Mission.
Alright guys, so real quick, we're actually just going to go ahead and steal the Eiffel Tower, but just so you know, the shrink ray was successfully used to deal with the crime lord, and now the science team has managed to create a portable version that can be attached to a helicopter. I don't really know how it got more portable than it fits in my desk. Anyway. Interrupt the Bastille Day celebrations in Paris by shrinking and stealing the Eiffel Tower, then revel in the chaos and national indignation. Yeah, take that, people who we stole an universally recognized trademark or landmark from. Why wouldn't you be mad? Anyway, I just thought I'd read that little bit of fluff text. So apparently we did shrink that guy. We didn't blast him into nothingness. But again, create a portable version. It was in my... wrong button. It was in my desk. What kind of shenanigans is this? Anyway, we'll just wait for that to pop. Be back in a bit.
Broadcast with shocking news regarding the latest exploits of a renegade evil organization. The whole world is aware their activities have become ever more brazen in recent days, but nobody was expecting them to carry out the threat to steal the Eiffel Tower. Eyewitnesses in Paris say what they saw was impossible.
They had this big laser on their helicopter. They used it to shrink the tower, then they put it in the helicopter and left. Mon Dieu! I cannot believe it! It is impossible!
So yeah, almost forgot that that was gonna pop. Sorry guys, you missed the first second of the broadcast, but it wasn't anything. It was just like one of, like another attention part of the message, but still, pretty funny. So, just figured I'd share that. Shit! So, Mariana Mamba. The super agent herself. Let's take a look.
Super agents are the world's top spies, or at least they like to think so. Every territory has one, and although seemingly invincible, they all have a secret weakness. Later, you will be able to uncover these fatal...
Shit up. It's not what I wanted. Just kind of gave away some of the surprises. Anyway, this is Mariana Mamba, Smash Super Agent. Mariana Mamba, a sultry, seductive super spy. It is unclear exactly how she even became an operative for Smash, but she has risen through the ranks to become their finest spy. Mamba grew up deep in the rainforest of the Amazon. Until her early teens, she had learned to hunt and survive the Amazonian way. It is quite likely that if it wasn't for a badly coordinated aerial strike by drug enforcement officers on a local drug baron's headquarters, Mamba would have remained a feral savage roaming the rainforest. But with her home scorched and most of her tribe dead, Mamba was picked up by Smash. With natural hunting skills and an exotic beauty that men seemed to find utterly irresistible, Mamba had everything for a glittering career as a secret agent. Dun dun dun. So, special ability. She has two. Savage Allure. Mariana has an exotic beauty that many find irresistible. Minions close to her presence find their loyalty to your evil cause sapped out of them, and may in fact leave your service almost immediately. And then Indomitable, which they all have. She is a super agent and cannot die in normal circumstances. She needs to be defeated in a specific way. You must discover Mariana's weakness before you can defeat her. Like other agents, she's assigned with a mission. However, super agents have two. She is a saboteur and a thief. So, she's mildly annoying. Mostly it's the Savage Allure that's a pain in the ass. She causes your minions' loyalty to drop, so she can kind of be a drain on your workforce. Fortunately, she's kind of squishy, so she's relatively... Let's take a look. So she has 80, 80, 80, 60, 80. So she's relatively easy to beat. I've read things that say that she's supposed to be one of the Charlie's Angels, but I think she actually looks more like... what is that? I hate to call her a Bond girl, but there is a Bond movie. I forget which one. And it's gonna bug me, but there is one of the girls in it. She's also a very capable agent who assists Bond in something.
Attention, citizen. This is
I was doing another one of these. And she looks just like this. She's got a knife, she's got the orange bikini.
But we need you all to perform your civic duties for us to operate successfully. Earlier today, a cabal of villains perpetrated an atrocity in the motherland. If you know anything about this event, or suspect anyone of being involved,
that's Mariana.
Contact your local Hammer official immediately.
This guy is still talking. But basically, the easiest way to deal with Mariana is to weaken.
Psychological weakening.
What the hell popped? Something popped. Oh, right, we have another optional mission to take care of. Which is down here. We'll deal with this one later. I won't even bother read the things. But... yeah, I was kind of hoping to steal the last piece of the totem pole, which had actually just popped, it looks like. But, I mean, we've kind of run out of time. Mostly Mariana ate up the last of our time. But, yeah, so we'll have to deal with her and get the last totem pole piece next time. Thank you very much for watching, and join me next time on Let's Play Evil Genius.